Sally, she will put you in bed when you're sick. Nurse Sally will put a bandage on your head. Sally, she will give you the medicine. Nurse Sally will take care of you. Of you.
Nurse Sally!
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato. What's that, Elly? You say it's time to tidy up? Pocoyo! Elly says you have to help tidy up.
Sick.
Are you sick?
Oh.
Nurse Elly says you have to go to bed. And you need a bandage. And you have to take medicine. Pocoyo, where are you going?
Pocoyo's Fairy Tales.
Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, a dinosaur was stuck in a tree. His friend the ant came to the rescue in a fire engine. Then the ant came to the rescue in an ambulance. Then the ant came to the rescue in a police car. The dinosaur was saved. But then the ant got stuck in the tree. So the dinosaur came to the rescue in the fire engine. And the ambulance. And the police car. The ant was saved. Hooray! The end. Pocoyo, I thought you were sick. Where should Pocoyo be?
In his bed!
That's right, in his bed. Now what does Pocoyo need?
A bandage!
He needs a bandage!
Yes, he needs a bandage. And what else does he need?
He needs medicine!
That's right, when you're sick you need to take medicine. Not again.
Wheel of Colors. Welcome to the show. Today's color is black. Everyone look for something black. Something black. What can you find? All right, let's see your pictures. black sunglasses, a black phone, and a blackboard. Good! Keep searching for black things. A black hat. Perfect. A black suitcase. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is?
A
black ant. Very good. Hooray for black!
Where can Pocoyo be? That sounds like Pocoyo. It is Pocoyo. Elly says you have to take your medicine, wear a bandage, and go to bed if you're sick.
Not sick.
What's that, Pocoyo? You say you're not sick anymore?
Wonderful! Tidying up is much more fun than being sick.
Five little aliens jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more aliens jumping on the bed.
Four little aliens jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more aliens jumping on the bed.
Three little aliens jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more aliens jumping on the bed.
Two little aliens jumping on the bed. One fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more aliens jumping on the bed.
One little alien jumping on the bed. He fell off and bumped his head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
no more aliens jumping on the bed.
No little aliens jumping on the bed. None fell off and bumped their head. Mama called the doctor and the doctor said,
put those aliens back into bed.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hi.
Are you planning a picnic today? Oh, I see. What a nice idea. Elly loves to go picnicking. Oh, dear. Elly looks, different, doesn't she? Yes, Elly, there seems to be something different about your appearance today. Can any of you tell Elly what's making her look different today?
Spots.
Now. It's all right, Elly. It looks like you've just come down with something. Don't worry. Pato, don't run away from Elly. The elephant spots are nothing to worry about. Elly will soon get better if she rests in her bed. That's all. I think Pocoyo has an idea. Oh, wonderful! You see, Elly, if you need anything, you can ring that little bell, and Pocoyo and Pato will come to help you. All right, then. Why don't you two head off for your picnic? Listen, sounds like Elly needs a hand. Oh, I think Ellie's thirsty. Ah, yes, there we go. Now, why don't you two go and have your
picnic?
Oh, there it is again. I wonder what's up this time. Oh, she wants a vanilla milkshake with toffee ice cream and a paper umbrella on top. All right. Well, if I heard correctly, Elly needs a watering can, a skateboard, a radio, a telephone, and lots of other things. I think you are better. Can any of you tell Elly how we can see that she's better?
Her spots have gone!
Exactly! Her spots are gone! No more spots! I think they're tired, Elly. Well, you know, they have spent the whole day running errands for you. I wonder where Ellie's going now. Yes, well, it looks like our friends will get to have their picnic after all. And I'm certainly glad Elly could come, aren't you? Hooray for picnics! And hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon! Pocoyo, Pato and Elly are building a tower. They're taking turns putting the blocks on. Hello, everyone!
Hi!
Ooh, looks like it might topple over. Sorry about that. done, Pocoyo. Now it's Pato's turn. Pocoyo's had a turn, Pato's had his turn. So whose turn is it now? Can any of you tell Pocoyo whose turn it is now?
Elly!
It's Elly's turn!
Oh dear, that was quite a sneeze, wasn't it? That's right. Let's try to build the tower again. Good job, Pato. Now it's Elly's turn.
Elly?
Oh dear, I think she's going to blow. Whoops, oh my. Ah, yes. Let's try again. There we go. Now, Pato? I wonder where Pato is. Can you see him, Pocoyo?
Pato!
You found him. Good work. Trying again, are we? Come on, Pato.
Pato!
Oh dear, poor Pato. Is he all right? Oh, Pato, there's no need to quack like that. But Pato, Elly isn't sneezing on purpose. People and elephants can't help it when they sneeze. It just happens sometimes. I think Pocoyo wants to help. That's very nice of you, Pocoyo. I don't think Elly is feeling too well. So maybe Elly doesn't feel like playing at all. Well, let's think. Where should she be if she isn't feeling all that well? Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Elly could go to feel better?
Go to bed!
Yes, Elly should go to bed. Resting is a very good thing to do if you have a cold. There. Maybe Elly will feel a bit better if she has a little sleep. Yes, Now you can build your tower without any sneezes knocking it over. Oh dear, I think Pato may have caught Ellie's cold. Watch out! Oh well, bye-bye for now. See you soon. Oh, there are Pocoyo and his friends. It looks like they're building a tower together. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Hi, Elly. Hi, Pato. Good catch, Elly. Everyone is definitely working together to build this tower. Oh, what's wrong with Pato, Pocoyo? What are those funny noises he's making? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and the others what's going on with Pato?
Hiccups! He's got the hiccups!
That's right! Pato does have the hiccups.
Hiccups.
Oh, don't worry, Pato. Hiccups are nothing to worry about. But they are rather annoying. Do you want to get rid of your hiccups, Pato? Maybe together we can think of a way to help Pato get rid of his hiccups. Oh, sounds like Elly might have an idea. Ooh, what is Elly doing? Oh, Elly wants Pato to hold his breath. Nice idea, Elly. Do you want to try it, Pato? Okay, Pato. Take a big breath on the count of three. One, two, three. Well done, Pato. That should do it. Oh dear. And it seemed like such a good idea. Oh, you have an idea too, Pocoyo. Oh, what is Pocoyo doing? Oh, I see. You think Pato can get rid of his hiccups by standing on his head. Well, what do you think, Pato? Want to give it a try? I say, I think this time it might have worked. Oh, well. That seemed like a very good idea too, Pocoyo. What's that, Elly? Do you think hopping on one foot might get rid of the hiccups? What do you think, Pato? It does look a bit silly, but you never know. Perhaps everyone should jump on one foot to make Pato feel better. Well, it was worth a try. What's Pocoyo doing now? Oh, he's holding his breath, standing on his head, and jumping on one foot all at the same time. What do you think, Pato? While Pato is doing that, I might know a way to get rid of the hiccups, but it's a surprise and Pato can't know about it. One way to stop hiccups is to give someone a surprise. You know, like come up behind him and say, boo! No, come back. Pato can't know that you're going to startle him. It has to be a surprise. Oh, hiding. What a good idea, Pocoyo. Why didn't I think of that? I've got another idea. Why don't all of you help Pocoyo and Elly say boo? So let's all say boo after three. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, our boo didn't scare him, but it started the tower swaying right behind Pato. Pato, watch out!
No hiccups.
It worked! The surprise that surprised everyone cured Pato's hiccups. Hooray for working together! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for hiccups! Bye-bye! Oh no, now I've got them! See you soon!
What have we here? Looks like Baby Bird, Pato and Pocoyo. Hello!
Hi!
Just look at them! Having a ball. Be careful, though. We wouldn't want to see you get hurt or... Pato, what are you doing up there? How did you... You're upside down. I know. This is very strange.
Pato?
Pocoyo? Pato is... he is around, just not where you'd expect. He's sort of, up there. He's, stuck. You don't believe me, do you? Can any of you help me? Can you tell Pocoyo where Pato is?
He's up there!
He's upside down!
You see what I mean?
Pato!
Oh dear, what are we going to do about this?
Jump, Pato, jump!
Wait, I know! Maybe Elly can help us. She's so tall. Perhaps she could grab Pato and bring him back down. Hurry, Pocoyo, go and find Elly. Now take it easy, Pato. Elly, we need your help. It's difficult to explain, really. Perhaps you should come and see for yourself. Yes, that's what Pocoyo was trying to tell you. You're going to jump. Ready, Pato? Ready, Elly? Let's all count. One, two, three! Oh, dear. This isn't quite working the way I'd imagined. Where's Elly going? Oh, I see.
Oh, oh, Pato, wait. She's... No, no, I think you've got the wrong... No. I think Elly has a plan. Go on, Pato. Ready, Pato? Jump! Oh, dear. That didn't seem to work either. Oh, I see. Pato's using his flying power. Go on, Pato! Oh, dear. Oh, poor Pato. Pocoyo, perhaps we should try to cheer Pato up a bit. Do any of you think that's a good plan?
Yes, cheer him up.
Now, now, Pato, don't cry. Oh, look, Pato, Pocoyo has brought you your favourite flowers and your watering can. Feeling better, Pato? And Elly has brought you something to drink in your favourite sippy cup. And look at this. So thoughtful. You're so lucky to have such good friends, Pato. With that alarm clock. I see.
You've played, and now it's time for some rest.
Pato, look at yourself. You came down.
Yay!
Well, what are you waiting for? You definitely showed Pato how much you care for him. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for friends!
Bye!
Bye-bye! See you soon! Oh, look, here comes Pocoyo. Hello, Pocoyo. Oops! Oh, my! Are you okay, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo what's blowing everything about?
The wind!
The wind! It's the wind!
Yes, it's the wind! Oh, look! Here comes Pato. Hello, Pato. Whoops! Oh no! The wind has taken your hat! Pato? What is it? Pato, please, I'd like to help you, but I can't if you won't tell me what's wrong. What's that, Pato? You think your head looks funny without your hat? But Pato?
Pato, Pato!
Pato! Pato! Pato, Pato, Pato! Play!
Play!
Pato? Well, I say, that's a dashing bird's nest hat.
Oh.
Will you go and play now? Uh-oh.
Pato, Pato! Pato! Pato!
Pato, why are you hiding from Pocoyo? Oh, you're afraid he'll laugh at your bare head?
Play.
Yes, that's the problem with cloud hats. They do tend to float away. Pato, are you sure you really want to wear a flower pot as a hat? Heavens! No, that's not really you, is it? Oh, surely not. That's a bit strange. No, that makes you look... This is getting ridiculous. Let's all tell Pato to stop.
Stop, Pato!
Well, I suppose that'll do as a hat. But really, you do look fine without one, Pato. Oh, no. Oh, poor Pato. He's really upset. Pato's afraid you're going to laugh at his head, Pocoyo. You know, Pato, everyone has things they don't like about themselves. Elly says she thinks her ears are too big. And Baby Bird wishes he weren't such a funny colour. And what about you, Pocoyo? And Pocoyo thinks he's too small. Me? Oh, well, as a matter of fact, I am perfect. No, actually, I think I'm too tall. But friends don't notice these sorts of things. They love you for who you are, not what you look like. What do you think? Do you still like Pato, even though he doesn't have his hat? And his bare head. Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye. See you soon. Here comes Pocoyo. And can any of you tell me what he's carrying?
It's a balloon!
That's right! It is a balloon! And a fine balloon at that! Pocoyo is upset.
He's lost his balloon. The balloon is gone.
Oh, look, Pocoyo!
Not Pocoyo's.
No!
See if I understand. You're not going to play with any of your friends until your balloon comes back. So if your balloon doesn't come back, you're never going to play again. But some things, like lost balloons, simply don't come back, and there's nothing anyone can do about that. I see. But Pocoyo, no one is stopping you from playing with your friends. You just have to decide to have fun again.
Yay!
That's better. Hooray for Pocoyo, and hooray for having friends who won't float away. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pato. What are you doing? You're wearing pajamas, you have a teddy bear, and you're in bed. I see, you're going to sleep. Good night. Oh dear, what's that? Uh-oh.
Now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. An alarm clock.
Pocoyo, it's not a good time to play. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato is wearing?
Pajamas!
Right, he's wearing pajamas. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato is holding?
A teddy bear!
Teddy bear!
Right. Can you tell Pocoyo what that is? Right. So, Pato is wearing pajamas. He has his teddy bear and he's in bed. What do you think he wants to do?
Sleep?
Exactly.
I stop playing!
I put away. I put away.
Meow!
Oh! Goodness!
Choo-choo. I put away!
Oh dear! Now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, jump! That's it! Jump, jump, jump! Jumping is fun! Oh dear. Fred says, clap! Come on! Clap! That's it! Clap! Clapping is fun! Fred says, run! That's it! Run! Run!
Run, run, run.
Running is fun! Fred says, that's all!
My bed! Pajamas! Sleep!
Are you going to bed too, Pocoyo? Now Pato can sleep.
Teddy bear!
That's Pato's teddy bear.
Good night.
Good night. Oh no! Poor Pato.
Now it's bedtime, I'm going to bed with my pajamas and my teddy bear. I'll turn off the light to sleep well. Good night, my friends. Now it's bedtime, I'm going to bed. I love the pillow that's under my head. Now it's bedtime, I'm going to bed. I'll say goodnight to my friends.
The alarm clock. Good morning, Pato. First, some morning exercise. Very good. Pato, it's time to make your bed. First, the blanket. Then, the pillow. Oh, look! Pocoyo is still sleeping. Let's all say, wake up, Pocoyo. Ready? Wake up, Pocoyo! Oh dear, he is really sleepy.
And now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A bed? Pajamas. A teddy bear. Now, Pocoyo. Looks like Pocoyo is still sleepy. Wake up, Pocoyo. Pato wants to play ball. Oh dear. Can you tell me where Pocoyo is?
Under the blanket!
He's under the blanket!
Pocoyo is still sleeping. How are you going to wake him up? Can any of you tell me what Pato has?
An alarm clock.
It's an alarm clock.
Now wake up, Pocoyo. And now it's time for Fred Says, that wonderful game where everyone has to get up and do what Fred says. Fred says, skip. That's it. Skip. Skipping is fun. Fred says, wave. That's it. Wave your hand. Waving is fun. Fred says, dance. Dance. Keep dancing. Well done. Fred says, that's all. Pocoyo is finally awake. But now Pato is sleepy. Can you tell me what Pato has?
A pillow!
A pillow. That's right. It's time to go to sleep. Uh-oh. Something tells me it's going to be a very long night.
I hear the alarm clock, but I don't want to get out of bed. I feel so sleepy, I want to stay here under the blanket.
Alarm clock! Bed! Pyjama! Teddy bear! Pillow!
I hear the alarm clock, but I get out of bed. I feel so sleepy, I wanna stay here under the blanket.
Ah, it's getting late here where Pocoyo and his friends live. And Pocoyo and Pato should just be settling down to bed. As I was saying, they should be settling down to bed. Hello, Pocoyo. It's getting very late, Pocoyo. Do you know what we usually do when it gets late? Pato is in bed. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what he needs to do next?
Go to bed!
Yes, go to bed! It's bedtime! Oh dear, I'm afraid Pocoyo doesn't want to go to sleep. But Pocoyo, everyone needs sleep. You don't need sleep. Are you sure? Yeah. Pocoyo, I think Pato is saying that he needs his sleep and your aeroplane sounds are keeping him awake. Oh, how nice, Pocoyo. All right, then. That's better. Good night. Oh, my. What's this now? Well, bedtime's really not the time for building block towers, Pocoyo. You can build another tomorrow if you like. Good night. Pocoyo? Pocoyo, bedtime isn't the time for playing with trains either. There you go, Pato. He's finally down to sleep. Now you can get some sleep yourself. Oh no! What's the matter, Pato? Can't sleep now, eh? Well, maybe I can help. Perhaps a little soothing music? Let's see now. yes. That didn't work. I know. Can all of you sing Pato the Lullaby with me?
Yes, we'll sing.
Are you ready? One, two, three. Well done. It looks like our friends are finally asleep. Good night, Pato. Good night, Pocoyo. And good night to you, too. Good night, all. And hooray for Pocoyo. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Good morning, Pocoyo.
Breakfast!
Of course. It's time for breakfast.
Yay!
There's milk, cereal, and orange juice. What's that, Pocoyo? You don't want milk or cereal or orange juice? Why not?
No!
Thank you.
No!
Oh dear. The Martian Brothers Show! Spoon. Knife.
Knife, it's a knife.
Fork. It's Fred. What are you doing, Fred? Making breakfast? Terrific.
Breakfast?
I think Pocoyo wants to have breakfast with you. What is it? Seaweed? Yummy. Hello, baby bird.
Breakfast.
Seeds? With caterpillar? Oh dear. Rocks for breakfast? Oh, dear. Animals, dot to dot. Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
It's a cat!
A cat!
Cat!
That's right. It's a cat. Can you tell Elly what Pocoyo wants for breakfast? What's that?
Milk!
Milk. And?
Orange juice!
Orange juice, right. And?
Cereal!
Milk and orange juice and cereal. What a delicious breakfast!
Yay!
Good morning, friend.
Good morning.
Now get out of bed. Do your morning exercises and also get dressed.
Good morning.
Now it's time for breakfast. You can have orange juice, eat delicious cereal, and also drink some milk.
Orange juice!
Morning, friend. Now get out of bed. Do your morning exercises and also get dressed. Now it's time for breakfast. You can have orange juice, eat delicious cereal, and also drink some milk.
Hello, Loula. Oh dear, you're getting very dirty. You know what happens when you get dirty, don't you?
Bath.
That's right. It's time for a bath. Come on, get in the bathtub, Loula. Oh no! Loula, come back! It's just a bath. It won't hurt you. Ah, Elly. Thank you. What's that, Pocoyo?
Soap.
Soap. Wonderful. And what's that, Elly? A brush. Great. Very soon, Loula will be nice and clean.
Surfing the net with Elly.
Hi, Elly.
Elly, search, Elly.
Pocoyo wants you to search for a word on your computer.
Clean.
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 Pocoyo wants to see something clean. Ah, it's Fred. Oh my. Are Fred's teeth clean?
No, they're dirty.
Clean, 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 clean. Clean.
I think we'd all like to see Fred clean those teeth. Ah, much better. It feels great to have clean teeth.
Thank you, Elly.
Yes, thank you, Elly. Well done. There. Loula is nice and clean. Uh-oh. Oh, dear. Here we go again. Can you tell Pocoyo what Elly wants?
The soap, the brush, the soap and the brush. Soap, brush.
Shape shuffle. A square.
Square.
A circle.
Circle.
A rectangle.
Rectangle.
Square, circle, rectangle. Ooh, what's this, Pocoyo?
MP3.
An MP3 music player. And you've made it with circles, squares, and rectangles. Oh, a speaker. Can you tell me the names of the shapes?
Rectangles.
And these?
Squares.
And these?
Circles.
square, circle, rectangle. Now Loula is really clean. Doesn't that feel nice, Loula? Uh-oh. This doesn't look good. Ah, good work. But it looks like someone else is dirty now. Yes, you, Pocoyo. Pocoyo, it's just a bath. It won't hurt you. Hi, Pocoyo. Hi, Nina.
Hey,
Dad.
Hey.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry. Hi, Loula. No, Pocoyo. Loula's not dancing. She's scratching. But why? Ah, Nina, you know what the problem is? Oh, you've got fleas. That's why you're scratching yourself. What can we do about it? flea party. Their dancing is making Loula itchy, and so she has to scratch herself. Made the fleas massage Loula instead of making her itchy. Congratulations, guys! Yeah. Everyone gets a massage, and the fleas can dance as much as they want.
Hello, Pato. How beautiful your flowers look. And that delicate aroma. Heavenly. What is it, Pato? Oh, yes. You're right, Pato. Something does smell really bad. Can any of you guess what smells so bad?
Loula smells bad.
I fear you may be right. Oh, dear. Hello, Elly. Is that new perfume? Oh, yes. It smells dreadful. Loula. Oh. Oh, my word. Oh, dear. Oh, hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
What have you got there?
Sandwich.
Ah, there's nothing better than a nice, tasty... Yes, I know, Pocoyo. Loula is very smelly. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what he can do to make Loula smell nice again?
Wash her!
Give Loula a bath!
wash her. That's a wonderful idea. Now, Loula, it isn't that bad. Now, Loula. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Pocoyo thinks it's time Loula had a wash. Maybe you could help him. Aha. You've got her! Oh, dear. Elly, catch her! Watch out! This is harder than it looks. What's this? Oh, I see. It's a cleaning machine. Brilliant. What? It doesn't seem to be working. Well, I have to admit, you do look very clean. Oh, Pocoyo, how will you ever give Loula a bath if you can't get her into a bathtub? Loula, you are a stinker. Can any of you think of a way Pocoyo can get Loula wet?
In the rain!
The rain!
That's right! Pocoyo can use the rain to clean Loula. Now that is one clean dog. Hooray for Pocoyo and hooray for getting clean. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, Pato. What a lovely living room. There's a sofa, a table, a rug, and a TV. Wonderful. Oh, look! Your friends are here.
Hi, Pato.
Pato, that wasn't nice.
The Martian Brothers Show.
TV.
TV! It's a TV!
Radio.
Radio, 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 radio.
Phone. Ah, popcorn. Delicious.
Hello!
Pato, your friends are here. Where is Caterpillar?
The table.
She's on the table.
Where is Pocoyo?
He's on the sofa.
And where is Loula? That's right.
Wheel of Colors. Welcome to the show. Here we go. And today's color is purple. All right, let's all look for something purple. Go. Something purple. All right, let's see your pictures. A purple ball, a purple umbrella, and a purple cup. Good job! Now keep looking for purple things. A purple car, perfect. A purple aubergine, beautiful. And this, do you know what it is? Purple alien! Hooray for purple! Pato, that's not nice. They are your friends. I wonder where your friends are, Pato. They aren't having much fun. Pocoyo, Pato would like you to sit on the sofa. That's right, Loula, sit on the rug. And Caterpillar sits on the table. What fun! Now everyone can watch TV together.
Welcome to my living room. My friends have come to be here with me. We all watch the TV. One sits on the table, one lies on the rug, some sit on the sofa. Sofa, one sits on the table, one lies on the rug. We all watch the TV.
Oh, do you hear that? What is it? I wonder who it could be. Can any of you help me? Who is that singing?
It's Pato!
Pato! So it was you. I had no idea you could sing like that. There you are. There's nothing Pato loves more than getting clean. How many showers is that today for you, Pato? Three? Oh, I'm sorry. Four, of course. You'd better get going, though. Pocoyo and Elly are waiting for you. Yes, indeed. Being clean certainly makes Pato happy. Pato! Pato! Look out for that! Phew! That was a close one. I think Elly and Pocoyo are having lunch. I wonder what they're having. Don't you want a sandwich, Pato? Messy, is it? Pato, why don't you come out now? I'm sure Pocoyo and Elly have finished eating now. Yes, they're bound to be playing something else by now. Now, where can they be? Finger painting, getting messy and having fun. Oh, dear. Yes. It's all right, you two. It's just that I don't think poor Pato wants to finger paint either. You see, he just took a shower. What is it, Elly? 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 Pocoyo? You know, Pato, you needn't be so worried about getting dirty. Yes, I know you're clean, but Pocoyo and Elly have finished painting. I wonder what they're playing now. It can't be anything as messy as painting, can it?
Muppie!
Oh, dear! Well, that was amazing, Pato! Not a spot of mud on you! Uh-oh. Wait a minute. Well, Pato was trying so hard to keep clean, but can any of you tell him what's happened? Yes, I'm afraid to say, Pato, you've got a spot of mud on you. Look. Pato? 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 You know, I was trying to tell you before, getting dirty isn't such a bad thing. No, no, it's true. Think of it this way. You like getting clean, don't you? Well, how much fun would it be to get clean if you didn't get just a little bit dirty first? Oh, look, how nice. Your friends even brought you a bathtub. I suppose Pato worked out that if getting a little dirty makes bath time a little more fun, then getting a lot dirty will make it a lot more fun. Hooray for getting dirty and for getting clean. Hooray for Pato. Hooray for Pocoyo. See you in the tub later. Bye-bye.
Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Can anyone tell me what Pocoyo is playing with?
Blocks?
No. I think what Pocoyo is playing with are... Oh, my. Well, yes, they are blocks after all. Well, blocks are fun to play with, too. Look, everyone! Hasn't Pocoyo built a lovely tall...
Clock!
What? That's odd. Where'd that clock come from? That's a great idea. A nice nap in the cool shadow of a magnificent leafy...
tree.
It all looks very tasty, Pocoyo. Perhaps a snack will do. So... are you going to make a sandwich? Good idea. First, he starts with a slice of...
bread!
Next, a slice of...
cheese!
Oh, yummy, Pocoyo! You've made a delicious...
bundle!
Well, that's nice. If you can't eat your sandwich, at least you can play the banjo. Yes, there's nothing more fun than playing on a... agree, Pocoyo. Let's get to the bottom of this mess.
Bye.
Oh, now I understand. Nina is playing magic words.
Furry.
Oh, very good, Pocoyo. A party. Something's missing? Bye-bye! Hi, guys. What are you reading?
Recipe!
And have you found something tasty? Looks like you found the perfect snack. And how is it made?
Berries.
Oh, I see. We need bumbleberries, of course. What are bumbleberries? Ah, a special delicacy that can only be found in the amazing bumbleberry forest. That's better. I think he likes you, Pocoyo. Nina says the berries highest up are the sweetest for baking. They grow all over the forest. Maybe you should split the group in two to collect them faster. This seems a good place to start. The bumbleberries look excellent.
Bye.
Pocoyo, why did we come to the forest? It? What teamwork! See? Pocoyo has found the best berries while bouncing. Ready to bake now. Good thing there's plenty of friends to taste this tremendous snack. Hi, sleepy bird. So, settling in for a nap? Pocoyo, you're making too much noise.
Sorry.
Pocoyo, this noise is making it hard for Sleepy Bird to take her nap.
I'm sorry.
What?
Shh. Good idea. Pocoyo promises to keep everything quiet from now on. He'll be your sleep guard. What's that? It's Nina and Roberto. They're playing tag. They're so rambunctious. I suppose tag is noisy, Pocoyo. But what can they do instead that's quiet?
Oh.
Ah, read a book. Much quieter. Pocoyo, it may be noisy, but Elly must practice her tap dancing. What a great idea, Pocoyo! Sorry, I'll whisper from now on. Try now, Pato.
Noise?
I don't hear anything, Pocoyo.
Shh.
I don't hear a thing. What now? You must have found every sound there is. Let's check on Sleepy Bird. Sound asleep. Well done, Pocoyo. Pocoyo? Sweet dreams, you've earned them. Bye-bye, all.
Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Elly.
Hi.
I wonder who that is.
Pato.
Oh, my. Pato says that he's going on an aeroplane and that he forgot his suitcase. Pato says that he really, really needs his suitcase.
I bring.
I hope they make it. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. Ah, what's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was an ant who went to the beach.
I love the beach.
He took an aeroplane and a ship and a motorbike. But once he got there, he missed his friend.
I am so lonely.
So he called his friend the dinosaur.
Friend, come play with me.
So the dinosaur took an aeroplane and a ship, and a motorbike. And when he got to the beach, he and the ant had a fun time. The end. Running with a suitcase is hard, isn't it? Wonderful idea, Pocoyo.
Bus!
You can take the bus. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what that is?
It's the bus!
That's right. It's the bus. Now you'll get to the aeroplane much faster. Wonderful idea, Elly. You can take a train. Can you tell Pocoyo and Elly what that is?
The train!
It's the train!
It's the train. Number menu. Time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 3 sandwiches. Very good.
3 sandwiches.
Oh dear. Well, how about 3 apples instead?
3 apples.
3 apples. Goodness. Poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
3 hearts.
That's right. 3. Looks like Pato is still waiting for his suitcase. Ah, there it is! Just in time. Sunglasses? Uh-oh, Ellie's mad. She rode a bus and a train and ran to the aeroplane to bring you sunglasses? Pato says, don't be angry. Look! You're going on the aeroplane too! Traveling is fun, but traveling with friends is even better.
If you travel on a travel on a train, if you fly on an aeroplane, always take your suitcase. If you travel on a bus, if you travel fly on an aeroplane, always take your suitcase.
Suitcase.
Your suitcase.